Griffin Pivateau is a man of many passions who's never been afraid to try something new. Originally from Lake Charles, Louisiana, the Associate Professor of Legal Studies and Business was just awarded the Oklahoma State University Regents Distinguished Teaching Award, recognizing faculty who have shown unusually significant achievement in the instruction of students for an extended number of years. He says he's doing exactly what he loves to do at OSU.
For me, the favorite part of the job is the teaching, the interaction with students, the opportunity to engage with people who are interested in learning about the world.
Pivateau got his bachelor's degree in history at McNeese State University, with plans of being a history professor someday. After 2 years of graduate study in the history program at SMU in Dallas, he was confronted with the market realities of the degree and decided to attend law school at the University of Texas instead. After finishing law school, Pivateau practiced law in New Orleans, Austin, and Houston. He loved the law, but he still had a place in his heart for teaching.
I always had this idea in my head that I would go back and be a college professor, because I was still living that sort of vicarious lifestyle of where would I would be had I finished that history degree. And so it dawned on me finally that I could still be a college professor, I could just need to teach the law. And so decided I'm gonna do it. I didn't know where to start. So I looked it up online. How do you become a college professor? And I saw the first thing you had to do is write. So I started writing and got an article published and was happy with that.
2 years after that article was published, Pivateau was hired as a professor at Spears Business. All of that writing ended up paying off. In 2016, the Nevada Supreme Court adopted Pivateau's proposal regarding the enforceability of non-compete agreements. The opinion echoed a 2015 decision by the Nebraska Supreme Court, which also cited Pivateau's work multiple times.
It was really vindication. Like, this is an argument that I made years ago, and to see it go out into the world and actually be put into practice, well, that's the best feeling you can have as an academic, that you are having an effect on the real world. Real people with real problems are relying on the solutions that you developed.
Being from a tight-knit family himself, Pivateau finds value in providing a supportive learning environment for his students. He's most excited about the new business building because of its open learning atmosphere.
I've always been a bit disappointed in my classrooms. You know, you go in and you want to have a lecture involving the students and interacting with the students, and instead they're trapped in this 5x7 desk prison. And so I'm really looking forward to getting into the new facility with the new audiovisual equipment, with the seating arranged that is designed to encourage interactivity.
When he's not working with students or researching, Pivateau is out on the open road. He owns 4 different motorcycles and enjoys spending his free time exploring rural Oklahoma.
That's a big part of my life. I mean, in terms of what I feel passionate about, I do feel passionate about motorcycles. I try to get out every weekend and ride around. And fortunately, here in the state, we've got a lot of places to ride and there's not a lot of traffic. I ride my motorcycle to and from work, because I think it's like the best way to start and finish your day.
Another hobby of Pivateau's is music. Whenever he has time, he plays acoustic guitar, sings, and writes his own music. Although as a kid he had dreams of becoming a rock star, he says he feels lucky to spend his days at Spears Business.
I've been very lucky in terms of my coworkers here. I love the students at Spears. We have a student body that overwhelmingly is composed of people that are interested in learning,